I've, you know, been the patient several times and I've seen wonderful care. I've seen, you know, care that I say to myself, gosh, that's what I really love, you know, and I'm going to use that. Or, you know, gosh, this is the worst deplorable care, you know, and it seems to get the worst of humanity. And it's like, why would you treat someone like that? Situation happened in 2007 when I found myself pregnant with my son, and they told me that I was sick with a condition that ultimately turned out to be a laboratory error, and they gave me a decision which would have been life altering for us. I'm kind of glad that I didn't go with, you know, the scenario that they were offering me, and I asked for more tests. But during that process, I was treated terribly, and I decided I never wanted anybody to have to go through something so horrible like that again. If I can buffer even a little bit to have somebody who cares, it's hard. You're scared. You're in the hospital because you're ill. You're hurt. You need to have that person who cares, who can say, you know what, we're going to help you instead of making you feel terrible. A lot of the things that are important to me is that remembering that that vial of blood or that specimen that you're receiving, it is a person, and making mistakes, you know, it's a life-altering, you know, life and death decision that somebody could be making, and it's all based on that one vial that you're receiving. And some people tend to forget that, and for me it's important to remember that there is a patient behind every single specimen, and to remember that and to respect that and to know that, you know what, somebody could be making a life decision based on the result that I'm going to give them. And for me, that's the time that's the most critical. I mean, I remember my son, if you're getting tired, if and so forth, he pops in my mind and he galvanizes me to keep going. He's, you know, my reminder every day.